Standard input, stdin, is one of the three standard I/O input-output channels that are available in Linux and other Unix-like operating systems. The three channels are standard input, stdin. This is the channel through which data is input into a program. By default, this is a keyboard, but it can be redirected from files or other commands. Standard output, stdout. This is the channel through which normal output is displayed. By default, this is a terminal screen, but it can be redirected to files or other commands. Standard error, saint error. This is the channel through which error messages are displayed. Like stdout, it defaults to the terminal screen but can be redirected. What qualifies as standard input? Standard input typically comes from the keyboard, but it can be redirected from a file or another command's output. For example, you can use a file as standard input to a command by using the less than operator. You can also use a pipe to take the output of one command and use it as the input to another. Commands like echo and cat go. The echo command does not usually take standard input. It simply prints the arguments you provide to standard output. For example, bash copy Cody Joe hello world cat. The cat command, on the other hand, can read from standard input. If you run cat without any arguments, it will read from the keyboard stdin and print what you type to the screen stdout. You can also use cat to concatenate files and display them, or use it in pipeline to process text. Bash copy code cat file. TXT, grep search underscore term in the context of your goals. Understanding these concepts can be useful for both your job interview preparation, especially if you encounter Linux-related questions, and for the Encore Cisco exam, as understanding the fundamentals of operating systems is often part of networking certifications. Certainly! Exclamation mark. Let's clarify what standard input, stdin, is and what is not. What is standard input, stdin? Standard input, stdin, is a channel used by programs to receive input data. Here's what qualifies as stdin. Keyboard input. By default, stdin reads input from the keyboard. When a program is waiting for input, you can type it directly into the terminal. Redirected files. You can redirect a file to be the standard input for a command using the less than operator. The contents of the file become the stdin for that command. Pipe commands. Using a pipe operator, you can take the standard output of one command and use it as the standard input for another command. What is not standard input, stdin? Here's what does not qualify as stdin. Command line arguments. When you pass arguments directly to a command, those are not read from stdin. They are processed by the program as parameters, not input data. Environment variables. These are not part of stdin. They are variables that can be accessed by programs but are not read from the standard input channel. Hard-coded values in program. If a value is hard-coded into a script or program, it's not coming from stdin. Output to the screen, stdout, or error messages, same there. These are separate channels used for displaying information and are not part of stdin. In essence, stdin is a specific channel used for inputting data into a program, whether from the keyboard, a file, or another command's output. Anything outside of this specific channel, such as command line arguments or environment variables, does not qualify as standard input. Understanding these concepts is part of the foundational knowledge in computer science and programming, and it could be beneficial for your upcoming job interview. Also, don't forget to keep up with your Anki cards to stay on track for the Encore Cisco exam. Certainly! Exclamation mark. If you want to fill the contents of example 2, txt with the contents of example 1, txt by redirecting standard input, you can use the cat command along with redirection operators in the Linux terminal. Here's a command you would use. Explanation. Cat example 1. Let's break down the difference between these two commands, and I'll also relate it to your goals by explaining how understanding these concepts can be beneficial in both technical interviews and network administration. SHA-1 sum less than dollar user. The less than symbol is used for input redirection. It tells the shell to read the content of the file whose name is stored in the dollar user variable and pass that content as the input to the SHA-1 sum command. If dollar user does not contain a valid file path, the command will fail, and you'll get an empty hash, .39A3E5E6B4B0D3255BFEF95601898FD80709, which is the SHA-1 hash of an empty string. SHA-1 sum less than dollar user. The less than symbol is a hear string, which is used to pass a string directly to a command standard input. In this case, the value of the dollar user variable, presumably the username Juposh, is passed as input to the SHA-1 sum command. The hash 073DB18E4B282,763,638FA2A9E9EC3E83A1F9AC6A is the SHA-1 hash of the string Juposh. Relevance to your goals. Job interview. Understanding the difference. Thank you.